Hello.
Xin chào.
This is Kyle.
And this is Chang Chibi.
From Hello Vietnamese, we provide Vietnamese lessons with simple and clear English explanations. Join us, and you'll be able to speak Vietnamese in no time. Since this is the first episode, let me talk a bit about myself. Again, my name is Kyle, and I currently live in Vietnam. Originally, I'm from the United States, but growing up, many of my friends were Vietnamese, and I thought I'd come here, which is why I am here now. How about you, Chang?
I am Chang. I was born and grew up in Vietnam. I was also living, working, and studying in the UK and the US, but I just came back to Vietnam more than 1 month ago. So Vietnamese is my native and first language. I can also speak English, as you can see, and Mandarin Chinese. I have studied Japanese. I can speak a little bit Japanese now, but I can say it is one of the failures in my life.
No, it's quite difficult. I mean, I speak Japanese myself, and even I think it's a bit of a hassle to learn the language. But anyway, in today's lessons, we will learn what, Chang?
Today, we will learn how to say hello and goodbye in Vietnamese.
Hello and goodbye, very important things. So let's start off then, you know, how do we say hello in Vietnamese?
There are many ways of saying hello in Vietnamese. The first way is say xin chào.
Xin chào.
Yes, xin as in scenery and chào with ch as in chair in English. But the ch in Vietnamese, in order to say ch in English, we need to push your mouth forward, but we don't have to push your mouth forward when we say the word chào in Vietnamese.
Okay, so just again, it'd be xin chào, right?
Very good pronunciation.
Well, thank you very much. Okay, well, you did say it's like, you know, it's a bit formal, right? So
it is not formal, but we rarely use it in kind of one-to-one setting. Normally, we say xin chào when you need to say hello to many people at the same time. For example, when we opening this episode, because we need to say hello to a lot of people from around the world, so I use xin chào.
I see. And okay.
When you come to a new company and you need to introduce yourself to everyone, you will say xin chào, but it rarely be used in one-to-one meeting.
Well, just from our listeners' curiosity's sake, then, what would you say in a one-on-one setting then?
One way is chào plus pronoun. And can you tell me a little your experience with pronouns in Vietnamese?
Oh, they're quite complicated. There's at least 12 dozen million of them for each little thing. But, you know, I find that they're all divided by age and gender and even occupation. And, you know, because of that, you know, the most casual ones are the most widely used ones are actually quite easy to learn. And
Yeah, and it is not only complicated, but actually there's no rule at all. We learn the rule just in order to break it. For example, you may know that you should call an older girl as chị, but later if you date her, you should call her em. So we learn the rule just in order to break it later. But today we will learn the simplest rule, and later we will learn more. So the first couple of pronouns you need to remember is tôi and bạn.
Tôi and bạn.
But it's very formal. You can use it to address people at the same age, but if you want to be more friendly or more casual, you may want to adjust it to mình and bạn.
Mình and bạn.
Okay. And next, we need to remember anh means older brother.
Anh.
Chị means older sister.
Chị.
And em means younger sister or brother. Assuming that if I am older than you, when I meet you, I can say chào em.
Right. And I would say chào chị.
I can also say chào Kai because you are younger than me. But you cannot say chào Trang because addressing name is a little bit impolite for people who are older than you.
Right. No, I can understand how that'd be. It's a bit too personal, right?
Mm. And for example, if you are older than me, when I meet you, I will say chào anh.
And I would say chào em, right?
Or
I can also say chào Trang.
Mm. Quick learner. And okay. And maybe that's all for hello in Vietnamese.
Okay. So xin chào and chào pronoun, right?
Mm, okay. Or maybe okay. Chào bonus name for people who are younger than you.
All right. Well, then, you know, since we're covering hellos, how do we say goodbyes then? Because I'm sure there are different ways to say goodbye in Vietnamese, right?
It is tạm biệt.
Tạm biệt.
Mm, correct. To have it done, tạm biệt. And you know, biệt means we break up, when we far from each other, but tạm means temporary. So tạm biệt means we been temporary, far from each other. It also includes the meaning of see you later in English. So tạm biệt, we been temporarily far from each other.
Right. Now that's kind of romantic in a way, because you know it already implies that there will be another meeting. I quite like that, but I'm sort of curious then, like, is there a more final way of saying goodbye then?
If you want to say goodbye forever to anyone, you can say the word vĩnh biệt.
Vĩnh biệt, right. Mm,
vĩnh biệt. Vĩnh means forever in Vietnamese.
Okay.
But I do hope that you don't have to say that phrase many often in your life.
Right. No, I mean, sort of final goodbye, like that. You don't use that in very specific situations, right?
You may say vĩnh biệt, for example, to a person who just passed away. Or if you have a girlfriend, or boyfriend, I don't know. And if you are very emotional, you can also say vĩnh biệt.
I see. So it's something that implies finality, like farewell or прощайте in Russian. Okay. So, okay, well, man, that's good to know. I'm sure all listeners agree. But, you know, just to review it then. So we covered hello, which is what again?
Xin chào.
Okay. And what if I want to say hello in a less group-like setting?
Chào anh. Chào chị. Chào em.
Right. Okay. So what about when we want to say goodbye then? What do we say if it's going to be a temporary departure from each other?
Tạm biệt.
What about, let's say, if there's a situation where unfortunately we will not be meeting again? What is that again?
Vĩnh biệt.
So there's our hellos and goodbyes then. But unfortunately, that's all for today. I hope you all know how to greet in Vietnamese from now on, and I hope to see you in our next episode. And remember, everyone, tạm biệt.
Tạm biệt.